Hi guys, Mike here, one go ShortPlay. Sorry, just trying to get my camera and stuff positioned right. It's getting a lot of headroom. I have to get my screen quite low to... Never mind, you don't need to... No. Humans, they were feared by everyone. Ooh, that went off the Batman-y, didn't it? Anyway, this is a Crusader of Centy. I'm messing with my volume now. Don't want to pick that up on the microphone if I can avoid it, because then I can't. You don't need to know. Okay, Crusader of Centy. I think this is an RPG, isn't it, of some sort? For the Sega Mega Drive. 94, so it's quite a late Mega Drive game, this. Yes. What's going on? Delete or move? What else? Get me to some sort of game. I don't want it. Oh, we haven't done this for a while. Do you remember doing this? Okay, I think it was because Amiga games generally ask you for your name. Where's the... I'll do it uppercase like I'm shouting. Wango! That'll do. Okay. And okay is down there behind my picture, probably. I mean, I can see it, but you probably can't see it. Because I'm probably there. Alright, yeah, it's all about Zelda. And now, the moment you've been waiting for, a birthday party, don't you hate it when YouTubers read the text that's coming up on the screen? We're not going to do that. He's 14, right? Basically, he's coming of age. It's going to lead to an adventure, I suspect. Yeah, see what I'm doing now. That's what I do every time I play one of these 16-bit RPGs. Just hurry up. I don't care. I stomached Zelda once. Oh, that's nice. Look at that. That's nice. I mean, I've programmed stuff like that before. A lot of work has gone into that. Anyway, can I hack that cake up? It's your birthday. Here's a sword. He's 14. He's not an adult. He's got a birthday cake, for God's sake, and loads of kids around the table. Why are you giving him a sword? Right. Yeah. Really? Alright. Okay, it seems I can interact with it. Ooh. I thought... Oh. Okay, I've got to just do the rat. See, this is dull. Yeah, whatever. I can see that... Oh. I still haven't turned that off. If you want to know what that was, look at a couple of videos ago, you'll see it. Fireworks. Okay, it looks like we're getting somewhere. We're getting progress. We've got to talk to the guests to make progress. Hero, hero, hero. Yeah, okay. We're going to be a hero. I don't know what my mum makes of that. She has given me a sword for my birthday, though, so I'm guessing she's up for it. Okay. It's pretty, isn't it? The shadows of the clouds are a bit annoying. I'm not that bothered that I need to comment any further on them. Take your sword, now is the time to fight. Sorry, I think I've got an allergy to one of my cats. This scratching thing here has been going on for a couple of days. And in my eye as well. I had to go see the optician before Christmas. I've never seen an optician to memory. I think I was about 7 when I last saw an optician, maybe younger. It was in Hunts Cross, so it must have been... I must have been older than 4, because that's when we moved there. I don't know where I'm going. I'm going there. I hope there's an adventure for me. He tested my eyes, because I was having problems. Oh, really? King? I'm 14? I mean, alright. You can't do what you gotta do, haven't you? Oh, no, I didn't press that. I pressed left. Let me in to somewhere... Adventure, that's what I want. I don't care if I'm walking on like nails or something, I don't know what that is. I thought I was going to jump in the water or something, but I don't care, because I just want adventure. I'm feeling, I'm not feeling very careful, I'm feeling reckless, that's the word. I take it these guys are pretty easy prey. Maybe I'm not supposed to kill them. Can I jump off? No. Yeah, optician, sorry, totally on a tangent. In fact, the optician story is really the tangent, but I'll tell you about it anyway. I can't remember why. Oh yeah, allergies. Yeah, it turns out your vision's 20/20, which is crazy considering last time I saw an optician was a long time ago. I'm getting hurt randomly. I'm allergic to my cat. Great. Where did that come from, you know? Right, my dad's allergic to cats really badly. But I never was. Then again, he wasn't until the point. one of my cats has got really coarse hair. Actually, when I was a kid, I did stroke a long-haired cat, and I think it had pretty coarse hair, and it just blew me face up, and I had to go to the hospital, and yeah, they basically came to the conclusion that I was allergic to cats, which was wrong. I wasn't. They were generalising. I was allergic to that particular cat. I already had a cat at home at the time. When my mum did, I was like a kid, kind of got old. Doesn't really matter. Am I getting hurt? Is it that green stuff I'm stood on? I think it was, boys and girls. Die, die. Anyway, yeah, it turns out Ginny, my little black cat that we rescued, well, we rescued all of them, to be fair. Well, we rescued, I told you a story, we rescued Ginny's mum, and she gave birth to Ginny in the car. Anyway, amongst other cats. Anyway, yeah, Ginny is quite coarse. Little black and white cat, no one wanted it, so we took her in. And turns out she a coarse fair. Irritates my skin, and not just that, she wakes me up in the morning sometimes by climbing all over the bed and getting in my face. It's just a cat thing, you know. Some people go, ooh, at that, but to be honest, I think most cat owners let the cat sleep on the bed. Ooh, that's cool. Didn't expect that to happen. In fact, I've just realised these are chests, not just background. They're just not very clear because they're quite bland. And that green stuff isn't very clear that it hurts you, but there we go. sorry, it's one whinge after another, isn't it? I don't really want to go down there. I took a lot of time and effort getting up there. I want to carry on. And randomly, I can't hit them. Where's the consistency? Oh, come on. I stepped on the grass and now I'm dead. Really? Yeah, anyway, Ginny got in my face, cuddled me, I cuddled back, and it turned out a cat hair got in under my eyelid, and my eyes got all funny, and I'm having drops, and it's doing me head, and I think this is all related to that. So there you go, it's the greatest story ever told. That was Crusader of Centy from Sega Mega Drive. I've played it before, I'm not that impressed with it, I'm not really into Zelda type RPGs, and it's because there's so much text heavy storyline, I don't really care. I like playing a game, I don't like reading the lore. Loved World of Warcraft, same problem. After a while, I just stopped really reading into the storyline. Game was good though. You know, Final Fantasy VII, that's the RPG I got into the most for the obvious reasons. It was great. It's time in context, it probably still is to be honest. But I only played the first couple of discs. I think I played the end of disc 2 before I finally kind of moved on to something else. And it took me a while. Good game. I get RPGs, I get why people like them. I'm just not particularly into that. Anyway, Crusader of Centy, Sega Mega Drive. Thank you for watching.